Hello, everybody. Richard Osman here. Welcome to the final of this week's House of Games, a festive special. I am very, very excited for four reasons. Reason one, it is nearly Christmas. Can you believe it? Reason two, Richie Anderson's trousers. You'll see them. Reason three, we have got a great final on our hands. And reason four, we just had a dog in the studio. You didn't even see the dog.
No.
How small was it?
I didn't see the dog.
Tiny little dog. Listen, it's the final. It's the big one. It's nearly Christmas, and somebody is going to win this Christmas trophy right here. Our players this week, let's meet them for one final time as we wait for Santa to arrive. They are Jessica Knappett.
Season's greetings.
Thank you. Richie Hello. Trousers Anderson. Debbie McGee.
Merry, merry.
Oh, and Simon Gregson.
Season's greetings.
Welcome. Jessica, when you put your trousers on this morning,
what did you think
you would have the second most remarkable trousers on the show?
I did not, and I really wish we'd spoken about this beforehand, because they have been somewhat trumped, haven't they?
Yeah, haven't they just? And talking of trumped, three wins in a row, but Richie...
Yes.
You won yesterday. That's why you're wearing golden trousers today.
That is exactly why. So my brief was MC Hammer meets Equality Street, and I think I've pulled it off all right, actually.
OK, MC Hammer meets Equality Street. Merry Christmas, one and all. Simon, yesterday, playoff. Little tiebreak against Richie.
Who'd have thunked it?
Wasn't it? Very
exciting.
There
was no way I was thinking I was getting more than 1 point.
So close. And today, if you win, it's double points Friday.
Yeah, well, clearly I'm going to smash it.
That'd be nice. Let's look at the weekly leaderboard, shall we? So at the end of today, we find our champion, Debbie, with 7, Simon with 8, Richie with 12, Jessica with 14. But 8 points would be nice today. Debbie, even with 8 points, we may be in trouble about winning the trophy. However, there are daily prizes still. And if you're wondering where the dog was, here are your choice of prizes. We have got the wheelie luggage in red, the candle, some eggnog, the mittens, and a doggy Christmas jumper.
Oh.
Ellie, the dog is called. And if you choose the jumper, Ellie will come and bring it to you at the end of the show. No pressure, though. No pressure, anybody. Simon, what would you go for?
You can't have the dog, obviously.
You can't. You can have the jumper. You get to stroke the dog.
I'm going to go for the wheelie suitcase, because I just think I'd look cool wheeling that around.
Debbie?
There was a miracle. I think I'd probably go for the case, actually.
Right. Richie?
I quite like the kudos of being seen with that suitcase in public because, you know, only a certain number of people can win that case. So to wheel it through an airport, people would be like, oh, he's been on House of Games.
Yeah. Exactly.
And won.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So go for that. Jessica?
Yeah, similar. I do love eggnog, but I also love being able to spot my luggage when it comes off the belt.
Okay, shall we? Very nearly Christmas. We have a small business of giving away a trophy. Let's do it, shall we? Our first round today is... Sounds like fingers on buzzers, please. I'll show you a category. Your first category today is festive food and drink. I'm going to show you some pictures. Just tell me what you see in the pictures and they will give you the name of some festive food or drink. So, what festive food or drink is this? Yes, Debbie.
Mint velvet.
It is not, I'm afraid. Simon.
Mint tulip.
I have absolutely no idea what this is. Jessica.
Mince pies.
Mince spies. We're looking for mint spies. We've got, you see. Next one. You might need to know the name of that character from the Tweenies. Shall I tell you the name of the character from the Tweenies and we can have a little buzzer race?
Yeah.
She is called Fizz. Yes, Simon.
Bucks Fizz.
Bucks Fizz is correct. Well done. Two Buck Deer there and Fizz. Next one.
Oh.
Lovely drink you might have. Warm you up. Jessica.
Hot toddy.
Hot toddy. It is hot air balloon, Todd, Carty and Jack D. Your next category is family films. Which family films are these, please? Do you know who that actor is?
It's Todd, yeah.
Yes, Simon.
Oh,
Welcome Matrix?
It is not Welcome Matrix, I'm afraid. Yes, Richie.
Matrix?
It is not, I'm afraid. Jessica.
Matilda.
Matilda. Oh, it's Tilda Swinton. Welcome, Matt and Tilda Swinton. Matilda. Next one. Yes, Richie.
It's not Alf.
It is not Alf, I'm afraid. It's going well, isn't it, this round?
What's that?
I'm sorry to make this so hard just before Christmas when all the family are watching at the same time.
Really making us work for that prize.
Shall I tell you? It's Kristen Stewart and Ralph Little. So it is Stuart Little.
Stuart Little.
That's what we were looking for. Give us an easy one. Give us an easy one, please. So I tell you who that is?
Yeah.
And we'll have a buzzer race. That is Post Malone. Yes, Simon.
Home Alone.
Home Alone?
Oh.
It is the Home and Post Malone is Home Alone. Well done. Next category. Figures in the Nativity story. Yes, Richie.
Joseph.
Joseph is right, Leslie Joseph. Joseph, we were looking for. Next one. Yes, Debbie.
Shepherds.
It is. Ben Shepherd and Ben Shepherd. Shepherds. Final question in this round. Which nativity figure is this?
Oh.
Yes, Richie. No.
Donkey.
Donkey. Don Corleone and a key is donkey. That's the end of that round. Let's take a look at our first leaderboard of the day, shall we? Everybody off the mark. Debbie, you've got 1 point. Richie and Simon, 2 points each. Jessica in the lead with 3 points. How about that? Not bad going, is it? Our final pairs game of the week. Let's see what it is, shall we? You complete me. Debbie McGee, you get to choose your partner today. You're in fourth place. Who would you like to play with?
Well, as I started with Simon, I think I should end with Simon.
Lovely. End with Simon. So, Debbie and Simon, you're a team. Richie.
Sorry, Simon.
And Jessica, you're a team. I'd like to call you Team Trousers. Now, in this round, I will ask you a series of questions, so fingers on buzzers. Every question has a two-word answer. If you buzz in, just give me the first word of the answer, please. Your partner must then complete the answer.
Mm.
OK? For you to score a point. Here's your first question. Which US comedy series first broadcast in 2011 stars Zoe Deschanel as Jess Day? Yes, that is Jessica.
New.
New is correct.
I don't know. York?
Is it New York? It is not, I'm afraid. Anyone on the other team want to buzz in? Nobody. Let's take a look. New Girl is the answer we were looking for. New Girl. Your next question is this. The acronym NASA for the US government agency stands for National Aeronautics and what? That is Richie.
Space
is correct. Yay. Jessica for the points.
I'm gonna go with agency.
It's agency. It's a good guess. It's not. Other team. What are we thinking?
Association.
Association, is that right? It is not. Mm. It is administration.
Oh,
we're looking for administration.
Well done if you've got that at home.
Next question. Which presenter who hosted Channel 4 News for 32 years left the programme in 2021? Yes, that is Jessica.
John.
John is correct. Richie for the points.
Why do I feel like it's Snow? Snow.
Snow? Merry Christmas.
Yay. It is
Snow. John Snow. Very well done. Next one. Who is this, please?
Ooh.
Yes, that is Richie.
Hannah.
Hannah is correct. Jessica for the points.
Eurovision.
No, I know. Waddingham.
Hannah Waddingham. Absolutely. Eurovision, Ted Lasso, all of that. Hannah Waddingham, next question. What is the title, please, of this song? The fuse is burning somewhere, it's drenched in heat, it's where I long to be. Yes, Jessica.
Good.
Is correct. Richie.
Enough.
Good enough.
Yes.
It is Good Enough by Dodgy. Very well done. Final question in this round. What's the first word of this answer, please? In the opening chapter of A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens, with what two-word phrase does Ebenezer Scrooge reply when wished a Merry Christmas by his nephew? Yes, Richie.
Bar.
Correct, Jessica.
Humbug.
Bar humbug. We don't hear that in this studio. It's absolutely right. Bar humbug. It's the end of that round. Could be a two-horse race. Let's take a look at this leaderboard. Debbie McGee, you have 1 point. Simon, you got 2 points. Richie, 6. Jessica, 7. Great round for you two there. What can we do to catch them up? It's Christmas, guys.
I think
it's Christmas.
Kill them off might be the end.
Debbie and me, I literally just said it's Christmas. that's literally what I just said. And that's your answer.
Richard. I'm desperate.
Let's do our next round, shall we? It is. Elephant in the room. Fingers on buzzers, please. The first thing we'll do is show you what the elephant in the room is. And today, the elephant in the room is. Nut. Lovely Christmas nut. I'll give you some questions. You must answer them. You must not say the word nut at any point. So leave the word nut out of any answer you give me in this round. Here is your first question. The Sugar Plum Fairy and the Mouse King are characters in which ballet with music by Tchaikovsky? Yes, that is Jessica.
The Cracker.
The Cracker. It is the Nutcracker. We lose the word nut, it's just the cracker. Your next question is, what are roasting on an open fire in the subtitle of the Christmas song recorded by Nat King Cole? Yes, Simon.
Chests.
That's correct, it is chests. Chest nuts. Absolutely well played, Simon. Next one. Which 1996 comedy film stars Eddie Murphy as a scientist named Sherman Klump? Yes, Simon.
Tea Professor.
The Tea Professor?
Yes.
It is the Tea Professor. Well done. The Nutty Professor becomes the Tea Professor. Next question. What is the title, please, of this song? 25 hours. Yes, Debbie.
Bush City Limits.
Bush City Limits. It is. Nutbush City Limits becomes Bush City Limits. Tina Turner. Next one. Which football move involving kicking the ball through the legs of an opponent shares its name with a spice? Yes, Richie.
Meg.
It is. Nutmeg becomes Meg. Well played. Next one. Don't say nut. What is the title, please, of this song?
There stands me wife, the idol of me life, singing roller, bowler, bowler, penny a pitch. Singing roller, bowler, bowler, penny a pitch. Singing roller, bowler, bowler, penny a pitch. Roller, bowler, bowler.
Oh, Jessica.
I've got a lovely bunch of cocos.
I've got a lovely bunch of cocos. Is correct. Well done. Danny Kaye's version there of I've Got a Lovely Bunch of Coconuts. Final question in this round. In a common abbreviation for a sandwich popular in the US that also contains jelly, PB stands for which ingredient? Yes, that is Richie.
Pea butter.
It is pea butter. Peanut butter become pea butter. Let's move on from that. Move on from pea butter, shall we? That's the end of round three today. Let's take a look at our leaderboard with two rounds to go, two rounds before we give away our special Christmas trophy. Look at this. Debbie with 2, Simon with 4, Richie 8, Jessica 9. And the two of you were pretty close on the weekly leaderboard as well. Two rounds to go before somebody takes away this disappointing trophy right here. Who is it going to be? Let's play round four, shall we? Today it is. Oh, no, it isn't. We normally call this round and the answer isn't, but because it's Christmas and Panto, it's called Oh, No, It Isn't. Jessica, I'm going to give you a question. There'll be four possible answers. One of them is correct. I'll score you a point. The other three were written by Richie, Debbie and Simon to try and fool you. And you will give them a point if you choose their answer. OK? So your question is this. According to its production designer, the 2023 film Barbie caused a worldwide shortage of what? Was it chiffon? Fluorescent pink paint? Fake tan? Or Barbie dressing tables? So one of those is correct, the other three were written to try and fool you.
They're all good, aren't they?
They're good. Be about time to lose a point, Jessica, wouldn't it?
It would.
Yeah.
There's quite a lot of pressure on this one, actually. Barbie could bring me down, not for the first time.
Yeah. Oh, she's trouble.
Oh.
She trouble.
I'm going to go with chiffon.
You're going to go with chiffon. What do you think at home on that one? Has Jessica just scored a point? Has she given a Christmas point away? Was the answer chiffon? It was not. She's given a point away. The correct answer was fluorescent pink paint was the correct answer.
Wow.
So who have you given a point to? Who wrote chiffon? Simon. Oh, well played, Simon. Put yourself a point. Nicely done. Good poker face as well. Fake tan. That was Richie and Barbie dressing tables. Was Debbie Richie? Your question now with four possible answers. Annabella Milbank, the future wife of the poet Lord Byron, coined what term for the adulation he inspired among his fans? Was it Byronists, Quilicious, Byromania, or Romantic Romanticism?
Quilicious sounds a bit modern.
Because quills are very modern.
But licious.
Oh, licious.
I think the licious bit sounds like something fairly modern.
Very 70s.
Like bootylicious.
Mm. I feel like Byromania, it's a bit sort of Beatlemania. I'm going to go for Romantic Romanticism.
It's nice, isn't it?
It just sounds like a lovely... It sounds like a perfume.
What have you bought me? I bought you some Romantic Romanticism. Sorry, you bought me what? Some Romantic Romanticism. OK. Imagine the meeting where they signed that off. Romantic Romanticism, says Richie Anderson. What do you say at home on this one? What do you think the right answer is? Has he scored a point, given a point away?
Oh.
Oh, he has not scored a point. So what was the correct answer? Byromania was the correct answer. So who did you give a point to? Who wrote Romantic Romanticism? Oh, that's a bad time to give a point to Jessica. I mean, Merry Christmas and everything, but that is... that's an error. Byronists was Debbie and Simon. Quilicious. Debbie, I have a question for you.
Yes.
There'll be four possible answers. In 2022, which term became the first Oxford word of the year to be chosen by a public vote? Was it meta-self, TikTok, totes, or goblin mode?
I'm torn between meta-self and TikTok.
Meta-self and TikTok.
Because I think totes, is that word's been around for a long time. Goblin mode I've never really heard of.
Are you on TikTok, Debbie?
I'm not, but, you know, I do know about it. And I'm thinking, well, it hasn't been going that long.
Yeah.
But it was... Well, I suppose it could be word of the year. It could be going before that. So I think I'm going to go for TikTok.
You're going to go for TikTok.
Yeah.
What do we think at home on this? Do you know the answer to this one? Would you have a guess at this one? Has Debbie scored a point or has she given a point away? Is the answer TikTok? It is not TikTok.
Who would lie to Debbie McGee?
Well, somebody has. Someone has disgraced themselves by lying to Debbie McGee. At Christmas, with Santa watching.
No, knowing I need the point desperately.
Exactly. I talked to Santa earlier today. He said he is watching this week and he's a big fan of Debbie McGee. So whoever's just fooled her, good luck staying on the good list.
Yeah.
Someone's on the naughty list. The correct answer was goblin mode. Goblin mode. is someone who's unapologetically self-indulgent and lazy. Somebody has just stolen a point off Debbie McGee. Somebody is not getting a visit from Father Christmas, OK? And it's the person who wrote TikTok. So who has disgraced themselves? Richie Anderson. In those trousers.
Wow. What this game does to you.
Wow. Met herself was Jessica, and totes was Simon. And Simon, I have a question for you to end this round. Your question is this. What was the title of the 1923 article by Charles Steinmetz in which he predicted that in 2023 people would work no more than 4 hours a day? I mean, Simon, you and I work half an hour a day, as people know.
Obviously.
Was the article called No More Hard Work by 2023? That's fairly on the nose. Maybe it's the right answer. Mm. Was it Part-Time World, The Leisure Seekers, or Work Less for Less? That's clever.
They're all very good, aren't they? I don't think it'd be Leisure Seekers. Just doesn't strike me as 1923. Speak. Work less for less. That's good.
It's clever.
I'm torn between Part-Time World and No More Hard Work by 2023. I'm going to go for No More Hard Work by 2023 because that would draw you in to the story, because that headline could mean, like, you wouldn't have to do anything.
What do we reckon, everyone, on that? Do you reckon it was No More Hard Work by 2023? Let's find out. Have you just scored the final point of the round? Was the answer No More Hard Work by 2023? It was! Congratulations! I just thought somebody before the show has been rushed and has just gone, No More Hard Work by 2023? Exclamation mark. Part-Time World was Debbie, Leisure Seekers, I would have gone for, I think. That was Jessica, and Workless, Fourless, very clever. Richie Anderson. That's the end of the round. Very well done, anyone at home who got 4 out of 4. Merry Christmas if you did. The leaderboard going into Answer Smash looks like this. Debbie with 2, Simon catching up a little with 6, Richie with 9, Jessica with 10.
Oh, God.
1 point between the two of you, and you are very close on the weekly leaderboard as well.
No.
Who's going to win today? Are we going to meet the dog? And who is going to win that trophy, I wonder? One more round to find out. It's been an unusual sort of Christmas week where you have 4 people around, you play games all day. I'm sure you're doing the same thing at home, but we're about to give away a trophy. Who's it going to? Let's find out, shall we? As we play Answer Smash for a final time. Fingers on buzzers, everyone. What a lovely week we've had. Thank you. It's been a pleasure having you here. Point for a correct answer, point off for an incorrect answer. Let's find our champion, shall we? Your first category is Christmas number ones. So we'll have a question. We will then hear a song, and you must smash the two together. So it won't be pictures, it will be songs. What is the full name of the character played by Jennifer Aniston in the sitcom Friends? And there's that old oak tree. Yes, Richie.
Rachel Green, Green Grass of Home.
Rachel Green, Green Grass of Home. Christmas number one for Tom Jones, absolutely. Green, Green Grass of Home. Next question, next song. Which green fruit, also known as an alligator pear, is a key ingredient in guacamole and... Yes, Jessica.
Avocado, don't you want me?
Avocado, don't you want me? It's absolutely right. Avocado and don't you want me? Christmas number one for the Human League. Next one. It's very close. What is the full name of the EastEnders character who was first played by Shane Ritchie in 2002 and...
We're
noticed you're just looking at those two, Richard.
Do you know what?
I can kind of understand it.
Rude of me. Simon.
It's gone. I was going to say Harvey Moon River.
Harvey Moon River?
It's not Harvey, though, is it?
It is not, I'm afraid. Richie.
Alfie Moon River.
Alfie Moon River? is correct. Well done, Alfie Moon and Moon River. Were you in the situation where you knew Alfie Moon but you didn't know Moon River?
Yes.
Whoa, how about that? Next category is very close at the top of this leaderboard. Christmas songs, just Christmas songs. Here's your first one. In a 1937 Disney film featuring the song Hi-Ho, which character bites into a poison apple and what is this song?
Just like the ones I used to know.
Yes, that's Jessica.
Snow White Christmas.
Snow White Christmas? It is Snow White Christmas. Snow White, White Christmas. This is so close. Next clue, next song. The World Heritage Site Machu Picchu is located in which South American country and...
Had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw...
Oh, yeah.
Simon.
Per Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Per Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer? It's correct. Well done. Peru and Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Per Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Next clue, next song. Ophelia, Horatio and Laertes are characters in which play by William Shakespeare? And...
How I'll hate going out in the storm, but if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm.
I'm just going to guess, Let It Snow, Thello.
Let It Snow, Thello? Is incorrect.
No!
Unlucky.
Oh,
that's so unlucky because he got the song, but the song comes second, don't forget. No one? Let's take a little look, shall we? I was looking for Ham, Let It Snow. Let It Snow, Thello. What a way. What a way to lose a point. Unlucky. Ham, Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Let It Snow. Any more? We are done for the week. We are done. Shall we find out who won Friday's House of Games? Richie had a right old go at it, but right at the last minute, our champion on Friday is Jessica Knappett. Well played, Jessica. Nicely done. That's four wins.
I'm so happy.
You've got a prize?
Yes.
What prize would you like?
Oh, that is a lovely dog. I will go for the wheelie luggage, please.
So you're taking the House of Games red wheelie luggage. Very well done. And we have a trophy to give away. Who has won our festive House of Games week? I think we know. Congratulations and Merry Christmas to Jessica Knappett. Well played, Jessica. Nicely done.
Thanks.
That's good, isn't it?
I have never, ever won a trophy.
No way.
Yeah.
And now look at you.
Now look at me.
Thank
lovely
you
Christmas
for
present.
A lovely week, everybody.
Thank you so much for watching.
I hope you're all geared up for Christmas. If you're not, if Christmas is a hard time for you, have a good one, have a peaceful one. But if you've got people around you as well, you have an absolute cracker. We've had such a lovely time.
Oh, thank you so much.
Absolute treat spending the week with you. The treat spending the week with you as well. We'll see you after Christmas on the House of Games.
Hello, doggy. Hi.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Oh, you.
She's beautiful.
Oh.
Merry Christmas, one and all.
Yay.